I'm going to start off by asking you a few questions, and I want you to raise your hands. How many of you enjoy flying in the typical airline experience? How many of you got in an aircraft in the last month? Wow. How many of you swore at an airline because they lost your luggage? How many of you swore at yourself because you arrived at the airport too late and you missed a flight? And how many of you were affected by the strikes that we had by Lufthansa and Deutsche Bahn in the last 24 hours? Okay, thank God, not so many people. So now, I want you to imagine you're on your way to the airport, your taxi's stuck in traffic, your heart starts to beat faster. Sounds pretty familiar, right? But imagine the airline was able to locate you via their app, calculate your new time of arrival to the airport, and automatically book you onto the next flight. Not only that, if all your further travel arrangements were automatically synced, so the taxi driver on your arrival knew your new arrival time, and also your hotel knew your new check-in time, or if you arrive early to the airport, the airline automatically rebooks you onto an earlier flight. And not just that, imagine if you had on this app the ability to locate your bag at any point in time and track where it is. This probably sounds a bit like science fiction. Today, air travel is far from being a hassle-free experience. But in theory, the airlines know a lot about us and the way we fly and the way we travel. I myself am an avid traveler, and as you heard, I've been fortunate enough to visit 117 countries. I'm passionate about traveling and helping others to experience the beauty of travel. But when I think about the many frustrations I've had, for example, when I've been in Bangkok trying to find out how do I get a visa to go to Myanmar, or when I'm trying to fly to Karachi and my flight's been diverted to Lahore because Karachi airport had been bombed, how do I get a new flight to Karachi? Or when I arrived in Damascus and my bags didn't arrive. Oh, and by the way, if there's anyone from US Homeland Security listening, those were purely leisure trips. So my vision today I'd like to share with you is a hassle-free travel experience enabled by innovation, but which is also environmentally sustainable. Now, also through my work, I have an interest at Lufthansa in monitoring long-term trends and innovation and improving the customer experience. I believe the topics of innovation and digitalization will revolutionize the customer experience over the coming decade. Now, what I'm about to describe requires advances in data analytics, but also thoughtful consideration of privacy. We should have the right to control what data we share, with whom we share it, and how it's shared. This vision I will describe is a win-win for us and for the airlines. By offering to share our preferences and our data, the airline can offer us an enriched travel experience and be our partner along the journey. Let us now take a deeper look at the next step for airlines. Now, once we start thinking about our travel, we start dreaming and planning. We go online. Today, we see that the internet has really revolutionized the way that people search for travel and has really enabled us to find the lowest possible airfare, which gives us power over the airlines. It also means that more of us can travel because it's become cheaper. But actually, in the next decade, what will happen is that power will shift back to the airlines. The airlines will know, based on, for example, checking weather in foreign destinations, looking at travel guides, or contacting friends in far-off places, that maybe we're thinking about planning a trip. And they'll be able to offer us a suggested itinerary before we've even really started planning that trip, in the same way that today Amazon makes product suggestions. But they have to be careful not to go too far and respect our privacy. There was one example of a European consumer loyalty program, which was based on shopping patterns, able to identify pregnant women and offer them special offers on baby products. The issue was that they were so good at identifying pregnant women, they were able even to do it before the women themselves realized they were pregnant. So we have to be careful. When we travel in future, it would be possible to be offered a customized bundle of offerings that's a package of goods and service around your flight, tailored individually to your needs. So suppose you're like me, you only travel with carry-on luggage, you generally like to eat a meal on board the aircraft, and you like having the seat next to you empty. The airline will be able to give me credit for the fact that I don't check in a bag and subsidize this towards my meal. So they'll be able to offer me something customized exactly to my needs at a price point designed for me. Also, what we'll see is, what we see today is that whenever we go online, the majority of times we actually don't buy anything. We don't buy that flight. And that's because we don't find the price we want, we don't find enough seats, the destination is not available, or the time of the flight is just not convenient. Actually, in the future, the airlines will start mining this data, the millions of searches which are going on, and they'll be able to offer us better offers because they'll know actually what we want rather than what they think we want. Now, many people spend a lot of time planning their flights. Actually, often it's quite nice to be more spontaneous. Sometimes I play a game called Airport Roulette, where I show up at the airport, I look up at the departure screen, I think, where would be interesting to fly to this evening? Based on what's the weather, what's the price, what's the flight time, and I just simply pick a destination for the weekend. But there's probably not too many people out there as crazy as I am. But having said that, in the future, airlines will be able to offer us more examples of mystery destinations where you say, I'd like to go on a beach trip this weekend somewhere in Europe. You won't know the destination, but it will be cheap, and they will select something for you based on their available seats. So this will allow the more adventurous of you to be more spontaneous. If we move to the next stage of travel, now getting ready to book, what we see is in future, the majority of bookings will be done on mobile devices or on iPads. It will be much faster than today, often with one-click booking, and your travel preferences will be saved, making it very easy to book your flight. Now, imagine you like flying to New York. It's one of my favorite destinations to fly to. You like going to the theater, and you like going shopping for clothes. So what will happen after you book, you'll be sent special offers on Broadway shows. And actually, during your travel, if you're walking through the street, maybe you're walking past a clothes store with a sale, you'll get an automatic notification on your mobile device letting you know that there's a sale on for that particular clothing retailer. Also in the future, pricing will be done much differently. Today, pricing is very simple, based on whether an airline thinks you're a business traveler or a leisure traveler. In the future, they'll be much more sophisticated. They'll recognize the fact that I actually buy a lot of ancillary services from the airline, that I have a high degree of travel spend. And so they'll be able to offer me a lower ticket price in order to get me in their system because they know I'll be a profitable customer. This is happening today in the casino industry. So people who spend a lot of money in casinos are actually offered either free or subsidized airfare by the casino operators. So now you're on your way to the airport. Typically, the next experience with an airline is checking in. So in the future, there'll be no check-in. You'll be able to go straight to your gate. The boarding pass will be automatically sent to you at the time of booking. And you'll be sent an RFID baggage tag just to put on your bag, and you won't even have to wait in line anymore. In the future, you'll be able to connect with fellow passengers before you fly and either share a taxi or a ride on the way to the airport. Or maybe the airline will suggest to you that you're both going to the same hotel. Maybe you want to share a ride. Even better, they could tell me who's on the aircraft and who's single and who likes playing airport roulette. Now, on the way to the airport, it's typically a very stressful time. And this is a good chance for the airlines to win the moments which matter. So now imagine you're stuck on your way to the airport. Maybe you haven't even realized. But on your mobile device, automatically you'll get a map or an alert telling you you're not going to make it to your aircraft in time. Or maybe they'll tell you that the security waiting times are particularly long right now, so you need to allow enough time, or there's traffic on the way on your way to the airport, so you need to take a different route. Also, when you arrive at the airport, A map will be displayed on your Google Glasses or on your mobile device, telling you exactly where you need to go. When you arrive in the airport and you go to the lounge, in future, you'll be able to have a connected lounge experience. And this is already being worked on and being launched this year by one airline. You'll be able to pick up an iPad, or if you have your own device, you'll be able to use that and control your entire lounge experience. Booking a massage, booking a shower, controlling the lighting in your shower room. Maybe if you like the wine on offer in the lounge, you'll be able to order a case directly to your home when you arrive. And also, when you're in the airport, you'll be able to already start watching your in-flight entertainment from your own device, and then bookmark what you get to, and continue watching in-flight. OK, so now let's move on to the most interesting part of the in-flight experience, that's flying. In future, you'll be able to control the back of the screen from your own device and have a second screen experience. Today, 70% of people at home use multiple devices, so you'll now have that opportunity also in the air. Content you like will be preloaded on the system, and you'll have your favorite TV shows, magazines, and newspapers already loaded, which is also environmentally efficient because we don't have to now carry around newspapers and magazines. Now, today, we have many funny examples of people trying to mount their own device on the back of the seat. Here's some real-life pictures. Now, some people go for the simple idea of just putting it on the seat back. We've had examples of people sellotaping their iPhone to the back of a monitor. Someone even created out of paper a mount to put on the back of the seat. In the future, it will be much easier. Lufthansa Technik has just developed a seat mount, which allows you to put your own device, power it up via USB, so you have it powered, so you can watch your own device throughout the whole flight, including takeoff and landing. Also in the future, cabin design will be much more interactive. One airline is currently trialing out a mood blanket, which changes color based on your neurological waves and senses whether you're in a pleasant state, quietly sleeping, or you're actually quite anxious. In the future, we won't need noise-canceling headsets because we'll have the true sound of silence in the air, and the whole aircraft will be pretty quiet. One manufacturer is trying now windowless aircraft, so there'll be images projected along the side of the aircraft, so you'll see the outside on the inside. Also, in the future, seats will look different. There'll be more of a morphing mass, which is customized to your body, so it'll be much more comfortable. And the seat will also be able to monitor your health and alert the crew of any problems. Also in the future, biofuel will be a lot more important and will be represented in a lot more flights. Today, the technology for biofuel is now pretty advanced and will almost be able to deliver it at the same price as jet fuel. And that's being produced by crops such as jatropha, from recycled household waste, or also from algae. This will enable one day someone to create the world's first green airline powered by biofuel. So hopefully a lot more environmentally sustainable. Also in future, the food offering will be much more customized. So it'll be no more just the simple chicken or beef question. By informing the airline of what type of food you like, maybe your favorite drink, the airline will know. This will also help the airline because they'll be able to reduce wastage and reduce weight on board. Also the cabin crew, we'll be able to speak multiple languages because they'll have a mobile device which will be automatically able to translate in any language you want and communicate with any passenger on board. Again, improving the overall flying experience and making it less stressful. So now, arriving at your destination could, in theory, in the future, be quite different. So today, when we arrive, we have to go through the airport, we have to get on a bus or a taxi, and it's quite complicated. Drone technology is now advanced enough that I could imagine in one day we'll be able to take a drone directly from the aircraft to our final destination. What we see now with self-drive cars from Google and also with drone technology, it's only a matter of time before this technology is able to introduce pilotless flying. Also in the future, forget about jet lag. These glasses have just been developed. They adjust the light based on your time zone. So in the future, you can arrive at your meeting and you won't be spaced out anymore. Also, you'll be able to share your pictures and your photos and your stories much more easily with fellow passengers in the future. And the miles, you'll be automatically notified when the miles are posted to your account, given suggestions for how to spend them. Maybe, for example, buying a bouquet of flowers to that person you met on the flight. So in closing, everything I've described is now technically feasible, and it's being worked on by the major players in the aviation industry. So hopefully you won't have to wait too long for these innovations to take place. Maybe they'll even be ready before the new Berlin airport opens. Today, air travel is the easiest way of making us look like our passport photo. Here's one example of my worst passport photos. In future, air travel will be so hassle-free that we'll look more like our graduation photo than our passport photo. Thank you.